Hey guys, welcome to Jay Hauser Writes. Thank you for joining me again for another video. So just finished filming the announcement of the book cover reveal and the pre-order being open and all that great stuff. And I promised that I would make a video on the book cover process. So this is kind of a sneak peek into the world of indie publishing. Traditionally publishing, the process is much less hands-on because, well, the publisher, your agent, they work with a cover designer. And in some ways I don't love it because you have limited control. Some ways I'm a little jealous because this was hard work. So let's delve into the process. The first thing for me was dabbling around with just making my own mock-ups. I had fun over Christmas break while I was chilling with family, you know, just watching Hallmark movies with my laptop and just coming up with designs. So I'm gonna show you how bad it is. Not great, right? It looks, well, first of all, definitely not done by a professional, and it looks very contemporary, which, I mean, this is contemporary fantasy, but primarily it's fantasy, so, you know, there's only so much that my very limited photo editing skills can do. So it gave a concept of what I wanted things to look like. And it did, I think, eventually help the cover designer that I went with. So I will have the cover designer's information down below. I communicate with him through email and also Facebook. He does also have a website. So he sells pre-made book cover designs, which often get snatched right up. And he also does custom, which mine are custom, especially in a world where I created fantasy races that others haven't written about. I couldn't just pick a cover that has, you know, a werewolf on it because, well, I didn't want to do the normal tropes. So I needed something a little custom, which even then, I mean, other than the ball of light and that, you can't really say like, oh, well, that's very clearly a different race because of the route we went. So I found him on a website and then we got to talking and, you know, then I looked on his particular website and his Facebook page, and I noticed that, well, first of all, he's mostly fantasy, and actually his brother is starting to design too and really impressed with his work too. So they do mostly photorealism using an actual model or combining multiple models. Spoiler alert, that is one girl's head and another girl's body. And I think he did a good job of merging them because I've seen some where you're like, oh yeah, those are not proportionate, like you can tell. But I picked out the pose and the model. And that was one thing is I noticed that there were kind of two different styles that he uses with his art, and the one I didn't really care for and then the other I loved. And so that's why I went with him, and he also had a reasonable prices. And so I gave him the rundown of what the story is about, the themes that I want. You know, we've got this creeping ivy along the side because that's one thing about the powers and the names of the enemy, the assassins that are out to hunt our main character, is that they are the ivies. And so kind of that sense of danger, that it's set in a high school hallway, and it just encompassed the things that I wanted. But he sent me three mock-ups and I didn't love any of the three of them. And I shared them with others. I've since, you know, hidden that post so people would hopefully forget and have more of a surprise at the cover reveal. But I particularly asked my beta readers that knew the story, and they all agreed with me in the fact that, oh, like that first one, like she's posed kind of sexily, or like, that's too short of a skirt. She would never wear that. I'm like, right, okay. I thought I was not getting the right vibe. So the cover designer was so great in working with me in showing me, like, here, this is the website where I get my licensed photos from, and this is the parameters you want for what you're looking for this project. And one thing is that I wanted series continuity, so I made sure that I'm using the same cover artist, and also looking for models that have different poses, have different facial expressions, that if they are going to continue in the series, that I have enough of that one particular model to fit the different books. So we did a lot of adjusting with like placement of things and how bright the lights are on the ceiling and how far and what angles. And yeah, so a lot of tweaking went into this. And I really appreciate the patience of the cover designer because I was a bit of a perfectionist on this. And I am really content with it. I am. Now, I know some people don't like cover art with characters on it. Part of that is genre specifics. This very much is in line with young adult fantasy, especially female protagonists, especially for indie publishing. Now, just like the book name, the book cover may not fit into the current trend with a lot of traditional books in the genre. Maybe I'm a snob, but I feel like they're all the same, like disgustingly the same right now. They're all a throne and castle and bed of thorns and ash and skulls and blood and feathers and snakes. Like, I swear, can't differentiate them. And all the cover art is the same too. So that's not my series. You know, someday I may do a recover of, you know, like of the completed series. And that's honestly a regular marketing strategy. You'll see probably dozens by now of different covers for even like the Harry Potter series. That's just a regular thing to kind of freshen it up every once in a while. So I'm sure someday I'll do non-character art covers as well. But for now, this is what we've got. And I've already got the covers ordered for books 2 and 3, and we'll be ordering book cover 4 soon. I will say that it is very important to go with someone that's professional. If you're indie publishing, you really, there's such a stigma about poor quality, and I did not want to get grouped in that. So I wanted to go with someone that knew things. And it's not just about making it look good. First of all, you have to make sure you are following licensing, copyright, trademark rules, that you're not just grabbing a picture from somewhere. There's a limited amount of copies of this that I can sell before I have to purchase a different commercial license. Like, that's an important thing to know. And if you're navigating on your own, like, you can definitely do it. Some people do teach themselves and put out quality work, but it is a lot harder. And that's one of those things I knew I needed to outsource. Part of it too is knowing, especially genre specific, what kind of fonts to use, where to place things on a page, just the balance and the color theme. And also, some printers print in RGB, right? Red, green, blue. And some are in cyan, magenta, the other one. Like, it completely changes the scale of the coloring. Oh my gosh. And then the templates you have to use to upload to the printers. Ooh, there's a lot. And my cover designer helped me through it. I will say one kind of flub that we had was the hard copy. We had some troubles with that. That brought me a lot of stress. And I actually have a video that I've already filmed with each unboxing of my physical proof copies. And the hardback gave me some grief. So I will show you here. This is the completed one, the final one. I don't have the other one right in front of me right now. But I learned that there's a lot more variation in things. And the template, working with Ingram Spark, that's the printer that's doing the hardbacks, the template is not as intuitive for the hardbacks as it is for the perfect bound paperbacks. So anyway, like, things were wonky off center. It did not look fantastic. So we had to go through that experience. That can waste weeks and also lots of money as you're paying for more shipping, more printing costs. But in the end, we did get it formatted. So that's one thing to know is, you know, my cover designer has been working in cover designs for 2.5 years, I think. So still kind of new in the industry. And I think not as many people in indie publishing focus on hardbacks because most people are going to do ebooks or paperbacks. So this is more of a guilty pleasure, I think, than anything, but I wanted it to be an option. And it was worth it to me to get it right. And going through all of the strenuous process of learning my own taste, learning my own strengths and weaknesses, and learning how to work with printers, I know that it will be easier to sort through what I want on book 2. I won't have to message him again and be like, you know what, that was centered and I really want it left justified. So that's another edit, and then whole new slew of files and saying, oh, well, you know what, that printed a little too much over here, so we need to center it more that way. You know, we'll know how to do it next time. So lots of learning. Give yourself so much time for your first publication so you can go through the trial and error and not have the breakdowns that I have. But I will say one last thing about making sure you're working with a professional, not just making sure that you have, you know, things legally correct, but also, you know, and to take some stress off of your plate and so you can make sure you're getting legitimate services. So I will mention it. Make sure to stop by my website and sign up for my author newsletter, because then you will get updates, promotions, bonus content. You will also get, I guess as bonus content, a free short story in this world. It's called Son and Soldier. It's a Cedar short story, and just kind of that slice of life that introduces you to the stakes and the kind of people we're dealing with and their powers. And as I wanted to have that up for promotion, you'll see on my website, that one is a handmade cover, at least at the time that I'm filming this. And I may get someone to redo it, but I knew that I did not have, you know, a couple $100 sitting around to have my professional cover designer do it for just a little short story that wasn't actually earning me any money. And so I turned to Fiverr, which I am not putting Fiverr down. I will be praising it so very much in other videos, and I already have in my map making one. You can see that. I'll try to remember to link it down below. But I try to find a cover designer on the cheap. Oh boy. Oh boy. I mean, you know, you get what you pay for sometimes. That's not always the case. I feel like my editors and my designer have been very affordable, because I think they're still kind of striking out there and building a name for themselves, and maybe just because they're decent people that do really great work, and I appreciate that. But I went with some random cover designer, and you know, they had maybe a handful of reviews, and I liked their work that they had displayed on the gig there. I think it was like $25 or something like that. And so I ordered it, waited, and it was like the moment I purchased it, I knew I shouldn't have. Because of the way that I felt pressured, they were misrepresenting their pricing and their timing. I won't go too much in depth about that, but what they sent me was horrible. Horrible. Nothing at all. And I sent her this, and I was like, this is kind of the feel that we're going for. These are the things. Added in things that I'm just like, no, no. I just hated it. And so I was like, you know what, just give me my money back, this is not gonna work. And she's like, no, let me do a revision. And I was like, you are not gonna make me happy. Like, I can tell from the level of work on here, there's no way you can edit this to make me happy. And so I applied for a refund. She denied it, and so she's just like, just give me another chance. So I was like, hey, here's the thing. Before I sent a reply, I looked at her, so I was like, why was it such poor quality? And then I looked at the pictures and of her examples of what she's done, because in her description it says she's done this for years. I looked up a half dozen of those books on Amazon, and I looked at the look inside feature, and I looked on the copyright pages where they acknowledge their cover designers, just like I have on the inside of mine. And shockingly, every single one of those cover designers was a different name and not this person. So the moment I was like, you know what? Even if you made it perfect, which I know you cannot, none of this is your work, and that's a lying misrepresentation and theft. And magically, they rejected the gig, and my money was credited. And they listed as the reason because they didn't have time anymore. Man, what a coincidence. Yeah, I reported them and their account is now gone. But I'm just saying, you can get shoddy work. Make sure to do your research. And I'll talk about how I've worked with my editors on another video. It's the same process of shopping around, asking questions, and always trying to be respectful of their time. Try to be thorough. I do feel so guilty every time I have one of the people that I'm working with being like, oh gosh, I should have mentioned this. So of course it didn't turn out the way that I wanted. I just didn't think that I hadn't been more clear. But you know, it's the meeting of creative minds. Anyway, I feel like I'm really rambling, and I don't even know if I've answered the questions that you guys have. So definitely ask questions down below. You do need different templates for, well, ebook, audiobook, paperback, hardback. And even then, you have to have a different template for the dust jacket versus the laminated cover for the hardback. And you need different covers for different printers. For example, I'm using both KDP, which is Amazon's private printer, and I'm using Ingram Spark, which distributes more widely across the world. They use different kinds of paper. So there's slightly different thicknesses, different parameters. So there's a lot to navigate. And you know what? Every penny that I spent was well worth it to me. So if you're looking for cover designer, this is kind of a catch-22 of like, I know that my editors and my designers deserve credit, but I also don't want people to find them because I don't want them to be too busy to work with me on my future projects, and I don't want them to be so busy that they have to raise their rates. But I know that's selfish. So I've linked the information down below. They deserve credit. If you have questions, again, let me know down below. Go pre-order my book. Go enter the giveaway that's associated with that. Go sign up for my newsletter. Share this. Please help me get it out. I quit my job. I need the money. And I deserve to be paid for the ridiculous amount of hours I've put into this journey. But I'm excited about it. Not bitter at all. I'm excited for people to get this in their hands and see something hopefully refreshing and different. Not only in new creatures and new magic, but, you know, I don't know, healthy relationships and things maybe a little less gritty, but still exciting. So thank you for joining me here on Jay Houser Writes, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.